Okay, so good morning, everybody. I was not expected to present something today, but so I tried to combine some presentation I had from Vincent and some I have to present to make a short presentation on the use of insecticide combination to control resistant mosquitoes. First, we will speak about Martinique because it was the original topic of this speech. So, but resistance of Aedes aegypti in Martinique, or Martinique is a French island in the Caribbean Sea. The only vectors of dengue and chikungunya, Zika, is Aedes aegypti, and population are strongly resistant to pyrethroids and organophosphate. There are several studies that was done, and several mechanisms were identified. There was 7 P450 belonging to CYP9 families and CYP6 family, and 2 carboxylesterase that are responsible for metabolic resistance. And there is also a high frequency of KDR mutation. The resistance level of population were determined using those response on impregnated papers. And we have a resistance level at the LC95 of around 70 for deltamethrin, 14 for pyrethrum, a mixture of natural pyrethrin, and 12 to NALED and organophosphates. So trials were done to evaluate the impact of this resistance on the efficacy of control methods. And the first trial were done in an open field area. It was a small scale field trial using a WHO cage bioassays. Treatment were done with 2 formulations of pyrethroid, 2 formulations of pyrethrin, and a formulation of organophosphate. So small cage were hung in the release. In the open field, where insecticides were released using thermal fogger mounted on vehicles. Cage was spaced from 10 meters, and every 10 meters you have 1 cage with a susceptible strain and a cage with a resistant population of Martinique. With the susceptible strains, we see that the knockdown in the cage were very high with all the insecticide, including the organophosphate. We have more than 80% of knockdown after 20 minutes in the cages, even at 50 meters of the release point of insecticide. But mortality was slightly lower for some insecticide like pyrethrins, where we have a decrease of mortality after 24 hours. But with the resistance strain, the resistance population of Vauquelin, issued for Martinique, you have a much more lower impact of pyrethrins and deltamethrin on the resistant population, with a very low KD effect. Especially, there is no KD effect after 20 or 30 meters from the release point of insecticide, and mortality with after. From 20 meters from the release point is also very low after 24 hours. Susceptibility, there is quite a good efficacy of the NALATE formulation, dibrome, but the dose was much higher than the dose of pyrethroid. That could explain maybe the effect. The impact of resistance was also evaluated at operational level now. In 9 localities, 3 localities were treated with a formulation of pyrethrins, Aquapy. 3 localities were treated with Cautrin formulation, and 3 localities were used as control. We put in each localities a cage in a house, and inside the house and outside house, to evaluate the efficacy of the treatment against susceptible strain and resistant population, and you see that you have a certain level of mortality in the susceptible strain, but no mortality in mosquitoes that are in cage. that are in the local mosquito, local resistant mosquito, that are placed in cage during the treatment. And we also measure the impact of the treatment on the number of female caught using BG sentinel traps. And we see that after three rounds of treatment, the space of 3 to 5 days, there is almost no impact of deltametrin and piretrin among the mosquitoes that are collected in traps outside the house, and inside the house, we have a slight decrease after the sun treatment, a slight decrease of mosquito collection in deltametrin in localities treated with deltametrin. So a strong impact of insecticide resistance at operational level due to the pyrethroid resistance of population in Martinique. The idea of insecticide combination is to combine active ingredients with different modes of action. It's one of the main strategies for insecticide resistance management, and it's largely used, especially in agriculture, but not really in public health. The idea is to simultaneously expose the mosquitoes to more than one toxic compound to increase the mortality, and it's largely used in medicine also for the treatment and the prevention of resistance in infectious disease for viral infection like HIV or bacterial infection like tuberculosis or parasite infection like malaria. Some models, mathematic models, gave a superiority of combination over rotation or mosaic for delaying resistance, especially in some cases when resistance to each molecule is present at low frequencies, when resistance to each molecule is monogenic and encoded by loci that are independent, when there is no cross resistance between molecules, when resistance is functionally recessive, it means that only the homozygous resistance are surviving to one of the molecules when treated with only one insecticide. Insecticides have equal persistence in terms of residual efficacy, and some of the population remain untreated to cross with the double homozygous that survive to treatment and to reduce the number of, to dilute in fact the resistance gene. So only the resistant homozygous to both loci can survive to the mixture or the combination, and based on this model, the probability is very low to have such kind of individuals. So just to remember that the crystal of BTI, the Bacillus thuringiensis israelensis, is a natural mixture, and there is no resistance detected in the field for many years of use of insecticide against mosquito population or simulium population. Some insecticide combination were tested for the larval control of Aedes aegypti in Martinique. Here we present the simulated field trial, and field trial were done in several localities of Martinique. Here I present trials that were done with pyriproxifen and spinosan in mixture or tested alone. And you can see that in breeding site, when you use the mixture, you increase strongly the residual efficacy compared to the spinosad alone or the pyriproxifen alone. We also did some insecticide combination to test the efficacy of some nicotinoids and deltametrin association on resistant population of Aedes aegypti in the lab. So this was done on impregnated papers, tested with various neonicotinoids plus deltametrin and a synergist piperonyl butoxide. So on this strain, we see that exposing mosquitoes to neonicotinoid only did not give mortality. But when you use low dose of permethrin plus a dose of permethrin PBO that give a low resistance, a low mortality on mosquito, you have a strong synergistic effect on the different nicotinoid against a resistant resistant strain of Aedes aegypti. There was also different trial done with treated nets, combined treated nets to control the resistant adult mosquito. So the first experimental trials were done against Anopheles gambiae and Aedes and Culex quinquefasciatis in Côte d'Ivoire, where populations are strongly resistant. So it was a combination of pyrethroid and carbamide met in the beginning of the 2000 years. And now there is a combination nets that are supported by IVCC consortium, and two nets are under phase two evaluation. The Interceptor G2 combined a chlorfenapyr, which is an insecticide, and alpha-sarpermethrin, a pyrethroid, a new insecticide, against resistant Anopheles gambiae. You can see that you have, against a resistant population, you have a low mortality with alpha-sarpermethrin alone, strong mortality with chlorfenapyr, but after several wash of the net, you don't have any effect. But on the combined net, the Interceptor G2, you maintain a strong efficacy until 20 washes. Another strategy is proposed by Sumitomo to associate piriproxifen and permethrin. So piriproxifen is not toxic for adults, but it can sterilize females. And then you don't have a by combining the two insecticides on the net, you have a higher mortality of the against resistant mosquito, but also mainly 94% to 78% of reduction of progeny of females that are surviving to the olicet duo exposure. So it's a very good tool to to reduce the fitness of resistant mosquitoes in this that are targeted by this net. Sorry. So just to conclude, so insecticide combination for control of Aedes aegypti mosquito are promising tool because they can control resistant mosquito or delaying the resistance evolution. We have an urgent need of formulation for spatial treatment, since until now only pyrethroids or organophosphate are available for rotation, and resistance is already present or widely distributed to these two families of insecticides. It's an opportunity to include insecticides with new mode of action in public health, like new candidate molecule for IVCC, to reduce the possibility also of cross resistance with current mechanism present in the population. And other authors propose different combination with insecticide and repellent, or also insecticide or fungus. However, some questions need to be addressed by using this combination. The first one is the selection pressure induced by mixture containing organophosphate or pyrethroids in the area where there is already resistance to this insecticide family. And also, when we observe a synergistic action of the two molecules, what is the possible synergy of toxicity for the non-target fauna? Thank you.